Floodwaters may be receding in towns across central west New South Wales, locals feeling a range of emotions, but one of the overriding ones is a bit of anger building. This is Anthony Robinson carrying his dog to his car just moments before a wall of water arrived, smashing into his house, destroying all his belongings and changing his life forever.
Now, fortunately, Anthony is okay, and he had this to say to the Prime Minister as he toured flood-ravaged Eugowra yesterday.
Where have you been last week?
I've been overseas. Yeah, I was representing Australia.
So, understandably.
I've come straight away.
And Anthony joins us now from Eugowra. Anthony, just talk us through that exchange with the Prime Minister yesterday and why you felt it was important to tell him exactly how you felt.
Yeah, good morning, guys. It's an extremely important message to get to the Prime Minister and the Premier. We've had overwhelming support from not only our communities around our town, but all over Australia. And I just feel like, every time that there's a disaster, the government just leaves it up to every ordinary, everyday Australians to do the job, the heavy lifting, when it should be coming from the government.
Look, my friend, I think everyone felt your pain, or what we can only assume, to have a little bit of an insight into without actually knowing. But when we saw you yesterday with the PM, the PM has legitimately been away and he's done some pretty important work over there for the nation as a whole. Was it a big decision to try and confront him?
Yeah, it was. I'm not a person that likes to get in the limelight at all. I like my quiet little country life, but I understand that he's got his commitments. But he serves us, and he's got to realise that there are bigger things going on, especially in his country, that deserve his attention more than being seen on the international stage. He can go over there and look good as much as he likes, but in 2.5 years. If he hasn't done anything for Australia, he's not going to have the opportunity to keep on doing it after the next election.
Mm. You look at what your family's gone through. Your house is destroyed. Your family's in shock. I know there was a point where you weren't even sure if the kids were alive because they were up the street somewhere on someone else's roof. Everything you've gone through, we've seen politicians now come to towns which have been devastated and we hear the words. Do you feel that there is meaning behind it and that they are trying to help and do the best they can?
Well, I know our federal politician for Clare here, Mr. Andrew G, he's been tremendous. He's been here every day. He's been hosing people's houses out. He's been on the tools. Without him, this town would be lost. I don't know where we would be. He got food on the ground on Monday night straight away. Apart from that, it just feels like the politicians are coming through with their normal slogans and not much information apart from that.
Look, I've known the PM for a long time, and I think he genuinely feels in these situations. Are you comfortable with the help that you've been offered from state and federal governments at this point?
So at this point, I was made aware of the new grants that just came in for primary producers and for small business owners. We're very thankful for anything that we can get from the government, but 90% of our town aren't either one of those things. We've got pensioners that no one's given them a loan to rebuild. We've got people that are out of work. How are they going to pay back a loan?
And insurance as well on top of it now.
Insurance and that's probably the biggest thing is that, the biggest help from the government, if they can't find the money themselves to give to us, then lean on the insurance companies, get them to pay. We've got people that have paid 40, 50 years of insurance and they're just getting told no.
Yeah, it's outrageous and a lot of people angry about it. Anthony, really appreciate you coming on this morning. Thank you, mate.
Hope you're doing okay, mate.
No worries. Yeah. Yep, no, we're okay. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Strong town. Communities along the Murray in South Australia are lashing out this morning as they prepare for a once-in-a-generation flooding event. Let's go to Nine's Sam Mills, who's in Adelaide. Sam, the Premier, unveiling a multi-million dollar support package.
He did. Good morning, Ali. Crunch time is fast approaching for residents in the Riverland, many facing the reality that their home or business could soon go under. Work is underway in places like Manham to build flood levees that will help to protect many properties, but it is a town divided, with around a dozen on the riverfront set to be left defenceless. Now, further upstream in Wakery, the town's ferry has been shut to assist with planning, as SA Power Networks prepares to shut off the lights of a further 680 customers by the end of the week. Premier Peter Malinauskas, he did tour the region yesterday, announcing a $51 million support recovery package. That includes one-off payments and rental assistance for those who will be displaced by flood waters, as well as money for damaged road and ferry infrastructure and mental health. Now, modelling at the moment shows river flows could peak at a massive 250 gigalitres early next month. We'll get a further update on that from the government tomorrow. Ali?
Thanks, Sam.